Okay. 56 degrees. Good enough to ride, but I noticed I had a squeak today when I went to get out. So what I've done is I'm going to show you. I'm going ahead and taking my little hand pump here and got it on my rear shock here on my 13 Royal Star Venture. And sure enough, there's not much pressure in here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pump this up now. Well, I'm going to put it up to about 40, 45. You can see I'm pumping it up. So essentially that shock had little to no air in it. I'm going to go ahead and pump it up. Again, this is a 2013 Royal Star Venture. Okay, so, all right. That's the rear shock. Okay. And that's off. Let me put the cap back on. It off. Put the cap back on, but you can see. And I'm gonna put the cap back in here. Okay. Now, while I'm here, I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna do a quick check over here on these fronts. Here, let me get you a picture down here so you can see. Right here. Yeah. My goal is to put about seven PSI. I'm just gonna do a quick check. I gotta get the cap off. Okay, and I gotta thread this in room. Lay the cap down. Get down here where I can thread this in room. Okay, now, and you can see it's showing hardly anything at all, so I'm just going to hit it just to put a little bit in there, as it's showing almost nothing. Okay. I'm unthreading it. Well, I had eight smaller fingers. Okay, I'm gonna put the cap back on that one. Now there's another one on the other side too. Check. Let me get this cap back on. And I'm gonna spin this so I can get access. Turn all the way to the right here. And we'll come around. And we'll do the same with this side. Boy, that's on tight. Whew, that is tight. Somebody has over tightened that. Let me get something. Let's see if I can kind of break that hold. There we go. Maybe that's broken. There we go.
I'm gonna get this off.
Again, that one was threaded on, I think, a little crooked. Somebody may have been here before. Okay. And now I'm gonna put my little pump on here. Let me feed it in here. And again, it's not a lot of space there, so. Kind of like doing the old bicycle tires. You had to thread them on. Let's see, I don't know if I've got that. I don't know, I don't think I did. Let me come at a different angle. There we go. Get a little lower. All right. Okay, now I'm not gonna put much in here. Let's see if it's registering. You can see the scale showing nothing. So, and you don't want a lot in these front ones. I think the manual says something like 7 PSI. So I'm just gonna barely put a little in here to get it up to about 7. All right. I'm putting a little in there. And that's about 7 there. So I'm going to leave it right there. I'm going to unthread this. All right. Try turning it this way to help with it. Okay, and I'm gonna put the cap back on. Now, if you watch some of my other videos, I gave you a contact information for someone that can rebuild, replace your rear shock if it starts leaking on you. I'll put my tools back up here. But, save yourself some money. And if you need a rebuilt rear shock, find that video. But don't overinflate these either. And as I showed you in an earlier video, get you one of these. This brand here is Fox. A little hand pump, and I bought it off eBay. Somebody was selling it, so I got a good price on it. And that's how you air up your shocks. Now, I think if you look at your service manual, it tells you on the front and rear pressure. So hopefully that'll eliminate my squeak I had, I noticed in the shock today. We'll see. Now, there's no evidence of my shock leaking. I don't think it's a leaking problem at all. But we'll see, and I'll report back if I find out otherwise. So here we go, a 13 Royal Star Venture. Hopefully this is helpful, and enjoy.